Hi friends, welcome back to the brand new series on Angular Zero to Hero, a perfect Angular guide for beginners. In my last video, I have explained about attribute directives and how we can use ng-style and ng-class in our application. In this video, I am going to explain about the communication between components. We have seen before how we can use different data binding concepts to pass data from HTML template to the TypeScript component and vice versa. This communication happens in the same component. We can also communicate from one component to another. Let me explain this using an example program. I have created an Angular application and started the server. We can see the application is running. Now let me create two new components. First one I am naming as parent and second one as child. Now we can see the components are created. I am going to delete all the code inside app component.html and I am adding parent component there. Now we can see the parent component in browser. In parent component.html, I am adding a div and then inside that I am adding a heading tag followed by an input element to get some text. And after the div tag, I am adding the child component. In child component.html, I'm adding a div, inside that I'm adding a heading tag and then a paragraph tag to display some text, in which I'm using string interpolation to display a value from TypeScript component. Let me also add some CSS styles in both components so that we can differentiate parent and child components. Okay, looks good. Now instead of hard coding this value in the child component, I need to pass it from the parent component when user types something in the input box. How can we do that? Let's see. In parent component, I am binding a variable through two-way binding. Let us also declare this variable in TypeScript component. And we know that we have a property called channel name in the child component. So we can use that to bind to this variable in parent component using property binding. And as we have used ng model directive in parent component, we need to import the forms module. Let's import. Okay, we may think it will work, but we are getting an error: channel name is in a node property of child component. It is clear that channel name is a property of child component, but why Angular is saying this error? In Angular, all the properties present in a component is not visible outside of that component by default. So in order to use that outside, we need to inform Angular that the value will be coming from outside of this component. We can do that using the decorator at input. So let me add that. This at input decorator should be imported from the Angular core package. With these in place, if we type something in the parent component, the data will be passed to the child component. We can also specify the default value in parent component. I hope you understand how we can pass data from a parent component to a child component. Now let's see how we can pass data from a child component to a parent component. For that, let me create an input element in child component. Let's try to pass this value to parent component when user types something in child component. If you see, in parent component, we have access to child component, and so we bind the data using property binding. But if you see in child component, we don't have access to parent component, so we cannot follow the property binding approach in this case. We need to use an event binding and an event emitter approach. Let me explain that. First, I am creating an input event binding and calling a function in the input element of child component. So we don't need a two-way binding here. Instead, I am using an event binding. Let me pass the dollar $event. So in TypeScript component, let us see whether we are receiving the right value. Okay, we are getting this value. So we need to pass this to parent component. In other words, we need to emit this to parent component. For that, we can use an event emitter. And we have to import the event emitter from Angular core package. And then inside the function, we can use this event emitter to emit any value, like this. So the setup in the child component is done. Let's move to the parent component to receive this emitted event. In parent component.html, we have access to the child component. So there we shall add an event binding to capture this event and bind to a function. Let's verify whether we receive the value from child component. We are not receiving because, like I said before, the properties will be visible only inside that component. So we need to inform Angular that this event emitter is going to emit an event outside this component. For that, we can use another decorator at output. This also we need to import from Angular core. Now we can see we are able to receive the data from child component. So in parent component, we can create a variable to receive this data and show it in the HTML like this. This is how we can communicate between a parent and a child component. This type of communication will be useful when the components are immediate parent-child or not more than two levels. Assume that you want to communicate between sibling components. In this case, you need to pass the data from first child to parent and from parent to second child. So this will be complicated when the app grows. Assume you have a component structure like this and you need to communicate from this component to this. If we are using this approach in this case, we need to pass the data all the way to the root component, and from there we need to pass the data down to the last child. So it's going to be a nightmare. But in Angular, we have other ways to solve this. One such solution is through services. Yes, in our next video, we are going to learn about services, dependency injection, uses of an Angular service, how we can create a service and use it in our application. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, please subscribe. And before we wind up this topic, let me suggest one task in this topic and you can try it out. Create an application like this. In parent component or in app component, keep three buttons and create an array of objects with name and type. Pass that array to child component and display it through a for loop. When a button is clicked in the parent component, filter the array by type and send it to child, so that when a button is clicked in parent, you are showing the filtered items in the child. And then in child component, have a click event for each item and pass back the selected item to the parent component and display it in parent. Try this. If you are having any doubts, please post it in the comment section. And if you are not able to create this, you can get the solution code from the GitHub repo. I have provided the link in the description. See you in my next video and let's learn services in Angular. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe, press bell button and stay tuned. Thank you.